3.2 billion years ago, during a period of rapid evolution, a larger progenitor cell engulfed a smaller cell. These two species co-evolved into the modern-day eukaryotic cell and mitochondria. Although the mitochondria were indefinitely within the larger eukaryotic cell, they retained their own DNA replication systems from the past. This includes a unique mitochondrial polymerase called POLG. This allows for all mitochondria to conduct their own DNA replication.
Mitochondria, they're responsible for quite a bit of cellular metabolism. In fact, they produce approximately 90% of cellular energy in the form of ATP.
Yeah, but what you didn't know is that the mitochondria actually have their own DNA polymerase. It's known as polymerase gamma, and polymerase gamma is responsible for the replication of DNA in mitochondria and also for the maintenance of the content of DNA that's made.
You see, the mitochondria, they produce the energy in the form of ATP by using proteins that are on its inner membrane. Essentially, these proteins, they use high energy electrons to create a proton gradient, and the proton gradient then flows down another protein complex, which uses the movement of the protons to create ATP. Now where mitochondrial DNA polymerase gamma comes into play is it is responsible for replicating mitochondrial genome, which is important if mitochondria need to multiply to meet increased cellular energy demands.
Yeah, and the polymerase gamma also has a 3' to 5' exonuclease activity, but it's error prone, and so sometimes it could give rise to mitochondrial diseases because it makes errors when it's correcting mistakes.
So it's a beautiful fall day out here, and we're trying to sell the polymerase gamma to UT students. Buying a polymerase gamma, this is a polymerase gamma.
What does it do?
It's in your mitochondria. It replicates your mitochondrial DNA.
Andrew, you're in pre-med, is this true?
Mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell.
That's true,
yeah!
That's true! And you need this polymerase in order to replicate the DNA in the powerhouse, how exciting! Are you interested in buying the polymerase gamma?
Yeah.
I guess not, but we have other potential customers. She didn't want it either. Do you have any interest in buying a polymerase gamma? You do? Cool! Well, follow me then! I'm really interested in buying a polymerase gamma.
What is that?
This.
Why should I buy one of those?
Do you want to learn more?
I guess. I mean, I'm not really doing anything. I'm only watching school.
Okay, cool. Well, then join us. We got another buyer! To have a polymerase gamma?
I'm not really well informed, but maybe I could learn about it.
You would like to?
Yeah.
Okay, that's great. That's what we're all going to do.
Okay.
Currently, mitochondria are known to have one DNA polymerase called polymerase gamma, or POLG. This has two domains, a catalytic POLG alpha and an accessory POLG beta. The catalytic domain serves three enzymatic functions, exonuclease activity, proofreading activity, and polymerase activity. The active site of POLG alpha has an orientation much like nuclear DNA polymerase, with the addition of an exonuclease domain called exo. This allows correction of the polymerase activity without an additional exonuclease enzyme. The replicating polymerase activity occurs in the pol domain, which is linked to exo by a spacer. There is a high density of conserved lysine residues located at the palm position of the catalytic subunit. These are pertinent to the enzyme's fast processivity factor. POLG is fast. Most replicases have little processivity by themselves, generally 15 nucleotides or less per primer binding event. POLG is an exceptional example in that it can synthesize over 100 nucleotides per primer binding event. The accessory subunit POLG beta increases enzyme processivity even further. It does this by simultaneously accelerating the polymerization rate and suppressing the exonuclease activity. But this can come at a price, because a decrease in the self-correcting exonuclease activity lowers the accuracy of DNA replication. Though the function is well characterized, the exact mechanism of POLG has not been confirmed. There are two theories, but the more accepted mechanism states that each strand of DNA is replicated separately at two different origins. mtDNA helicase, also called TWINKLE, separates the two strands of mitochondrial DNA. Let's call them L and H. POLG uses the parental L strand to synthesize a nascent H strand. Meanwhile, mitochondrial binding proteins stabilize the parental H strand as another POLG synthesizes a nascent L strand. Therefore, two daughter genomes are produced in a semi-conserved manner, as is shown by this diagram.
But is there any other regulation mechanisms that regulate the function of this enzyme?
There hasn't been a lot on regulation of the levels of mitochondrial DNA polymerase that I know of. And there is certainly is still a mystery as to what regulates the actual final level of mitochondrial DNA and number of mitochondria within a cell.
As Dr. Ken Johnson mentioned, there hasn't been a lot of research done on the human POLG regulation. In fact, it still remains a question as to what controls the amount of DNA that's actually made in the mitochondria. However, regulation of POLG has been studied in smaller organisms, one of which is Drosophila melanogaster. The promoter that codes for POLG's accessory subunit in Drosophila contains a DNA replication element called DRE. It requires a binding factor called DREF. If DREF isn't functional, the accessory subunit doesn't work. DREF actually has a structural homolog in humans known as HDREF. Having discussed the mechanism and regulation of POLG, I wanted to inform my potential customers about the health consequences of a malfunctioning POLG in order to emphasize its relevance for human health.
So some of the mutations that are known actually are so severe that children die within a year or two after a horrible life of seizures and First of all, the mitochondrial DNA polymerase is nuclearly encoded and imported into the mitochondria, so it follows traditional, inheritance patterns, And we're working to try to understand that what happens with different types of mutations. Some mutations are really severe and they dominate and they become dominant, others are recessive. But the worst combinations for a child to inherit is to get one mutant allele from one parent and another mutant allele from another, and that leads to the most severe problems, Alper syndrome. There are other mutations, though, that are shown to be very slow onset. And in fact, there's virtually no effects until ages of 30 to 40, where there's sudden onset of blindness.
Alport disease is one of the mitochondrial diseases that affect mostly the brain and the liver. The cells cannot function properly without energy supply. And in the case of ARPAs, this leads to brain dysfunction, severe epilepsy, loss of developmental skills, and liver failure. ARPA syndrome is a progressive neurological disorder that begins during childhood and is complicated in many instances by serious liver disease. There is no definite cure for this condition, so most of the treatments are directed towards supportive care.
We began a project 20 years ago now, trying to track down some of the causes of toxic side effects of nucleoside analogs that are used to treat HIV infections. And it followed from the results of a clinical trial at NIH, supported by Eli Lilly, where they had a compound in a hepatitis B clinical trial, where it ended up killing 5 of the 7 patients it was given to. And at that time, they realized it was because of mitochondrial toxicity, and that then led to the suggestion that that could also be responsible for a lot of the toxic side effects that are seen with the nucleoside analogs used to treat HIV infections. And so these get incorporated into mitochondrial DNA. They act like chain terminators and stop and poison DNA replication. and that prevents then the replication of mitochondria. And in fact, it's a better substrate for the mitochondrial polymerase than it is for HIV.
Today we learned that mitochondria have their own DNA polymerase called mitochondrial DNA polymerase gamma, or POLG. It has an essential metabolic role because it replicates the mitochondrial genome to meet cellular energy demands. The POLG has three essential functions: an exonuclease function, a proofreading function, and a polymerization function. The trimeric protein has two beta subunits and a high lysine density at the catalytic site. This contributes towards the high processivity factor of this polymerase. There are two theories of mitochondrial DNA polymerization mechanism, but the more accepted theory is that the polymerase replicates at two independent origins on each strand of the genome. Although the regulation mechanism of polymerase gamma is not fully understood, we do know that mitochondrial DNA content is controlled by POLG. This enables mitochondria to divide independently whenever we need. Mutations affecting POLG can be detrimental and cause a host of debilitating symptoms, such as seizures, lactic acidosis, or weakness. One of the most severe phenotypes of a POLG mutation is Alper's disease. In addition, due to the similarities between viral DNA polymerases and mitochondrial polymerase, nucleoside analogs used to inhibit some infections can also inhibit POLG. This can prevent mitochondrial replication. The resulting diseases can even require other medications just to mitigate the side effects.
Which of you is excited and wants to buy the polymerase gamma?
You know, I was kind of excited, but you didn't really sell me on it, so not me.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, that's a blow to the ego. That's fine. Anybody else, Jim?
I'm sold. I'll buy it.
Really?
I'll
yes.
Buy it.
No,
awesome.
I need that polymerase.
What?
Yeah, for my lab.
Alex, you haven't said anything this entire time. I didn't know you wanted it.
Yeah, it's
mine now.
Wow. You know what? Don't worry, there's plenty of polymerase gamma to go around. It's in multiple mitochondria, multiple cells, all over. It's everywhere in mammals, it's everywhere in eukaryotes.
Your very own polymerase gamma.